Thank you. Hello, everybody. This is Pastor Jim Cymbala, and welcome to our Tuesday night prayer service. You've been seeing the prayer requests that come in from around the world, literally, on the bottom of the screen, and I thank you for praying, interceding, reaching out to God for people who are hurting, in need, in despair. And we fulfill that verse that says, pray one for another. But now we're going to change course a little bit here, and we're going to begin to praise God and sing along with the worship team and enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Let's do it right now.
Bless his name. Bless his name. Hallelujah. Gracias, Señor. Te alabamos, Cristo. You are holy, O God. Oh, let's sing that verse, our hope.
My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' love and righteousness. I did not trust the sweetest prayer.
Yes, Lord, we trust in your name.
But only trust in Jesus.
Let's sing that again, church. Sing to the Lord. He is Lord of all. Alabado sea tu nombre. Gracias, Señor. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, for you are Lord of all, oh Father. Thank you for your presence, Holy Spirit. We bless your name. Oh, church, let's just bless the name of Jesus. We bless your name, Jesus. Name above all names. Jesus, thank you for the cross. Thank you for the blood, oh God. Thank you, Jesus, for sacrificing your life for our sins, oh Lord. For this we thank you, we glorify you, we magnify you, Lord. Gracias, mi Cristo. Tú eres digno. We love you, Lord. Oh, just love the Lord. We bless you, Lord. We extol you. We exalt you, Lord. Chorus, in your presence.
Presence, Lord. In your presence, oh God. Let's lift up a hand. Lift up a hand and sing.
In your
Before we go further, I just want to remind you that yesterday, on Monday, three more episodes of the Believer series that you can download for free. There's going to be 30 episodes in all, and we're dropping three, releasing them three every single Monday. So there's three new ones out there in case you don't know about it. You might want to get the others that have been released. This is good food for the soul. This is Bible-based instruction for not just a new believer. Yes, there the beginning episodes were about what it means to be born again and what happened on the cross when Jesus died. But there's others, the believer and love, the believer and prayer, the believer and the Bible, the believer and church, the believer and what do you do when you mess up, and so on. So please take advantage of that. I'm excited that God has answered a prayer of mine. Other countries now are asking for it to be dubbed into their languages so that this can be made available to Christians of all different stages in Italy, in Italian, I'm going to put it in Spanish, God willing, in French, in Portuguese, and just think, a free download where believers anywhere can be blessed and nourished by the Word of God. Remember, you can call the church at 718-290-2000 with your situation, your need, your request, your question, whatever it might be. Call the church or visit the website. Visit the website, brooklyntabernacle.org. And you can not only leave your prayer request that way, you can learn what's going on with different ministries in the church. And just so you know, the pastoral staff is watching and listening every day to the latest updates from the governor, the mayor, about when will New York City loosen up. They say upstate New York is going to loosen up, but they're holding back on the city. The vaccinations are being made, and everything is still up in the air, but we're watching it because we want to get back into the house of the Lord to have a six-hour meeting from 9 in the morning till 3 in the afternoon. You can come, you can go, you can stay. You can stay for two meetings. The choir will go in, out, sing, eat, cry, pray, worship, thank God. Oh my goodness, what a day that will be. By the way, also giving, so important. Please remember us in your giving. January is the aftermath of Christmas spending. So a lot of people are short, but we can't be short. We cannot be short in paying our bills, supplying money to the missionaries who depend on us. And to this date, to the glory of God, we have not missed any of those payments. But it's only happened because of unusual giving from some quarters, your faithful giving. I want to give God all the glory and all the praise for putting it on people's hearts to give. So watch this. It encourage you about giving.
The Brooklyn Tabernacle has made giving simple through Secure Give. You now have three ways to give your tithes and offerings from the comfort of your home. You may use your cell phone to text BTGIVE and your gift amount to the number 74483. For example, to give $20, just text BTGIVE20 to 74483. Or click the Give Now button on our website at giving.brooklyntabernacle.org. Or download the Secure Give app on your mobile device and enter the Brooklyn Tabernacle on the search screen. Please go to giving.brooklyntabernacle.org for more information.
There's a great Bible school up in the state of Maine, and Pastor Matt Ward is the president of that school. And I had the pleasure of meeting him, speaking up at their school. It is in the boondocks of Maine. I mean, the mosquitoes can't find that place in the summer. But a school of faith, a school teaching the Word of God. And he's going to deliver the Word of God for us and get us ready to go to the throne of grace and prayer. So when he's done, I'm going to come back and lead you in a time of waiting and prayer to the Lord. Thank you and welcome, Pastor Matt Ward.
Well, good evening, Brooklyn Tabernacle. It's such a privilege to spend a short period of time in God's Word before we go and pray and seek God. What a privilege to be able to talk to God. Just want to share my and my family's love and appreciation for Pastor Jim and Carol Cymbala. What a mighty work that God has done and continues to do through these very important vessels. Honestly, I've done my best to try to recruit them to become fans of the Boston Celtics, maybe leave the dark side. But I tell you, this is not the year that's going to happen, and I don't know that that will ever take place. Would you take your Bibles and open them to the book of Exodus, chapter 12? While you're opening your Bible to the book of Exodus, chapter 12, the second book in the Bible, I want to kind of bring you up to speed. Israel is being held as a captive people in Egypt. Pharaoh has made them slaves. Moses has come back from the desert, and he's called to lead Israel out of this slavery. Pharaoh rebels, and 9 plagues are cast out onto the land. And of all 9 plagues, God protects Israel. Before the 10th plague comes, God has a message for Moses to share with his people. I want to read that. Exodus chapter 12, verse 21. Then Moses called all the elders of Israel together and said to them, "Go, pick out a lamb or a young goat for each of your families and slaughter the Passover animal. Drain the blood into a basin, then take a bundle of hyssop branches and dip it into the blood. Brush the hyssop across the top and sides of the door frames of your houses, and no one may go out through the door until morning, for the Lord will pass through the land to strike down the Egyptians. And when he sees the blood on the top and the sides of the doorframe, the Lord will pass over your home. He will not permit his death angel to enter your house and strike you down. Remember, these instructions are a permanent law that you and your descendants must observe forever. When you enter the land the Lord has promised to give you, you will continue to observe this ceremony." Verse 26. "Then your children will ask, 'What does this ceremony mean?' And you will reply, 'It is the Passover sacrifice to the Lord, for he passed over the houses of the Israelites in Egypt. Though he struck the Egyptians, he spared our families.'" When Moses had finished speaking, all the people bowed down to the ground and worshiped. Verse 28, "So the people of Israel did just as the Lord had commanded through Moses and Aaron." Amazing, amazing what God was doing for his people in a time of rebellion. While God was doing everything he could to convince Pharaoh that the best thing that Pharaoh could do would to be obedient and let God's people go. At the same time, God is protecting his people. At a time of judgment, the results of disobedience, God is still moving for Israel. Now, there are some that teach, I don't know if they're right or wrong, to be honest. Some teach that Israel at any time could have just walked out of Egypt if they wanted to. Perhaps they could have. I will draw your attention to this. Out of the 9 plagues, you don't see Israel respond the same way they did in Exodus chapter 12, verses 21 through 28. At this time, when Moses is sharing the message, the people of Israel immediately do what I don't see that they had done in the first 9 plagues. They hit the ground and they start worshiping. It's almost like joy had finally risen up in their hearts. Why didn't they rejoice every time God had been working to protect them through the different plagues? Here is where I want to focus our time together. And this is really what I feel like God has been speaking to me to share with you tonight. That while Israel had God in the camp, they still had Pharaoh in the head. God had been working for his people, and he was about to do something fresh. But it seems like that they were locked down in those 9 plagues because what was happening in Egypt politically had instilled such fear into their minds. While they recognized and had one foot in God's presence, the Pharaoh fear was in their mind and they were still restrained. A spirit of enslavement. When fear has come into these people's hearts and minds, it had locked them in. And quite honestly, I don't have to explain to those of you that especially are living here in America and there in New York, that there is a lot of fear that is entering the minds of all people, but even Christians. And we have to make a decision. Are we going to let, how do I want to say this? Do we want to continue to think that politics are bigger than God? Israel had, I believe, gotten to the point where they actually feared Pharaoh more than God. And yet God was still in the camp. My heart for you tonight, my prayer for you before we gathered here, is that any amount of fear that 2020 was able to get into your life, that I don't care if it's a little bit of fear or a great amount of fear, that starting tonight, as we get into his word and as we go to prayer, every ounce of fear that has entered your mind from the year that we have gone through will leave. And you realize not only is God in the camp, but God is in my house. What were the 3 things that happened that set them free from the fear of Pharaoh and gave them faith to move forward in God's plan? Let me tell you this very briefly. Number 1. You ready? Write this down, in fact, if you would, in the comments. An anointed message. An anointed message. When Moses got up to speak, or if it was Aaron, but it looks like it was Moses, when he got up to speak, the people did not just see Moses. You know Moses, he was called by God. When he was in Egypt, some decades before this, he saw a slave master beating a fellow Hebrew. And Moses retaliated and killed that Egyptian slave master. Had to run for his life like a fugitive. Ran to the desert. There became a farmer. God confronted Moses and said, Moses, I want you to set my people free. And Moses said, I can't. I stutter. Eventually he comes back. And it seems like all the people can see of Moses. Well, there's the guy with the record. There's the humble farmer. There's the guy that's not too eloquent. But this day, they began to look beyond the outside of Moses and they began to hear something that sounded like heaven. If we could ever stop being so distracted by the outward man, and if we could start getting in tune with the voice of God, Could it just be that there are some anointed ministers that nobody has heard of before right now, that as people get hungry, they will stop having to hear somebody who's incredibly eloquent, the most fluent with their grammar? Maybe they got the best modern clothes or the most modern look, but no, maybe we should stop looking at these things that don't really produce anything, and maybe we should start getting hungry for somebody who can share with us fresh bread from heaven. Every time I hear Pastor Cymbala speak, I feel like I'm hearing God speak. It's powerful. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 1. Listen to this challenge and this warning for us last day believers. I charge you therefore before God and the Lord Jesus Christ, who will judge the living and the dead at his appearing in his kingdom. Preach the word. Be ready in season and out of season. Convince, rebuke, exhort with long suffering and teaching. For a time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but according to their own desires, because they have itching ears, they will heap for themselves teachers. They will turn their ears away from the truth and be turned aside to fables. We need to hear people who will tell us not what we want to hear, but tell us what we need to hear. And that's a word from God. I'm afraid that many people are being drawn to the type of preachers that Paul warned Timothy about. I call them, well, Sammy Davis Jr. helped me. I call them the candy man preachers. The candy man can make the world taste good. I'm grateful for men and women of God, whether the world knows them or not, who will stand strong, stand with purity and with a heart of love and the anointing on their lives, and speak the gospel. When I hear the gospel, it changes me. And when Israel heard Moses get a word from heaven and share it with them, something happened in their hearts. They stopped listening to the blogs and the podcast of all the things that were taking place politically, and they began to hear a word from heaven. I'm telling you, Jesus said in Matthew 24, before the end of this time period, that there will be a commission of preaching the gospel all over the world. That's what we're doing at Faith Bible College International in Charleston, Maine. We're training preachers of the gospel. For 60 years, we've been sending them all over the planet. Please hear this. I want you to hear my heart. You may get emotional for a singer, but that won't save you. You may get emotional during a testimony, but that won't save you. You may be entertained by a Christian movie, but that won't save you. It's the preaching of the gospel. Jesus said this gospel would be preached. Why? Because he's not willing that any should perish, but that everybody gets saved. And he says, the greatest way I can get this harvest is to send a worldwide wave of gospel preaching. I thought of this the other day. If that's God's plan to save a generation, then quite honestly, I believe if I hear an anointed gospel, it can save my family. It can heal my body. It can renew my mind. I believe that it will bring Brooklyn Tabernacle to the greatest days of its history. They heard an anointed message that freed them from the Pharaoh fear. They caught a vision. Let me wrap this up quickly. Moses said, we're going to take a lamb and sacrifice it. I believe when they saw that sacrifice, they caught that picture in their mind. I believe the Holy Spirit put something in their heart. It was prophetic. We see something innocent giving their life for us. Please hear this. With a lot of things going on in the world today, Brooklyn Tabernacle, we need a fresh vision of who Jesus is. When they saw the Lamb, when I see the Lamb, when you see the Lamb that takes away the sins of the world, I promise you, it will lift your faith. I know a lot of people get divided and distracted. Well, what translation of the Bible do you read? Well, how do you water baptize? Well, when are you going to be raptured? I'm going to tell you something today. I just need to see Jesus Christ. Honestly, what does it matter which translation of the Bible you don't obey? Someone asked me, what do you baptize in? Water. I'm not going to let these issues get our eyes off Jesus Christ. He said, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto me. We need a fresh vision of Jesus. We can get all our lights right. We can get all of our sound right. We can get the temperature just right. We can get the seats just right. But only Jesus can satisfy your soul. Only he can heal your heart and make you whole. He'll give you peace you never knew. Peace, love, and joy, and heaven too. Only Jesus can satisfy your soul. Hallelujah. I wish I was with you in person. Here's the third point. I'd just like to rejoice with you. My third point, now I want to finish. The way we get Pharaoh fear out of our head is we need an anointed message. We need a fresh vision of Jesus, and we need to know that God has a plan for our home. Moses says, your homes are going to be just fine. Your homes are going to be just fine. I got a plan to protect your family. Got a plan to protect your children. I know that many parents have had to make some difficult and challenging decisions and had to make a stand. But I believe that as the Lord tarries, this next generation is going to remember when moms and dads of faith stood strong in the midst of some very challenging times. And perhaps our victories in this season will give them examples for victories for the next season. For Moses said, when we take the blood of this lamb, we're going to paint blood on the top of the door and the sides. This blood reminds you of your connection to heaven and to your connection to your brothers and sisters. Isn't this wonderful? Quite honestly, the most valuable thing you and I have next to our salvation is our family. We know in these days, there are dark times, the scripture says, that will come. But I need you to lean in and hear this. But he still has a plan for your family. An anointed message, a vision of Jesus, and a plan for your family. We should not be afraid or timid, for God is working on our homes. My wife gave me this little writing that she found, and I have found it so powerful, and it's encouraged so many parents. Give me a moment to read it to you. It's strong. Don't feel sorry for or fear for your kids because the world they are growing up in is not what it used to be. God created them and called them for the exact moment in time they're in. Their life wasn't a coincidence or an accident. Raise them up to know the power they walk in as children of God. Train them up in the authority of His Word. Teach them to walk in faith, knowing that God is in control. Empower them to know that they can change the world. Don't teach them to be fearful and disheartened by the state of the world, but hopeful that they can do something about it. Every person in all of history has been placed in a time that they were in because of God's sovereign plan. He knew Daniel could handle the lion's den. He knew David could handle Goliath. He knew Esther could handle Haman. He knew Peter could handle persecution. And he knows that your child can handle whatever challenge they face in their life. He created them specifically for it. Don't be scared for your children, but be honored that God chose you to parent the generation that is facing the biggest challenges of our lifetime. Rise up to the challenge. Raise Daniels, Davids, Esthers, and Peters. God isn't scratching his head wondering what he's going to do with this mess of a world. He has an army he's raising up to drive back the darkness and make him known all over the earth. Don't let your fear steal the greatness of God placed in them. I know it's hard to imagine them as anything besides our sweet little babies. We just want to protect them from anything that could ever be hard on them. But they were born for such a time as this. I know that in our hearts we carry our children so heavily. But I want to encourage you. Give your home to God. You know, the next generation doesn't have to grow up with fear. They can grow up with the greatest level of faith any generation has ever had. The greater the challenge, the greater the grace and the presence of Jesus Christ we can expect. So tonight, I want to, as we go to prayer, go to another level of prayer as our lives are affected by anointed messages. Holy Spirit reveals to us a fresh vision of Jesus Christ. And we're reminded that God has a plan for our home. Let me pray for you, Lord. I ask you, Holy Spirit, to let these words be more than thoughts. But God, let us take from your word and be captured by them. I pray for my Christian brothers and sisters at Brooklyn Tabernacle. I believe you, Holy Spirit, are going to draw these people together into that building at the right time, and these are going to be great, great days of progress and of gospel preaching. Lord, I pray for my brothers and sisters of Christ all over the world God, I pray that you'll help us to unite in Christ. If ever a divided world needed a united church, it's right now. Help us be hungry. Help us not to be a la carte Christians where we get this preaching we like and that preaching. But God, let us get the whole counsel. Anoint preachers to preach like we've never heard before. And Lord, we give our homes to you. I pray a covering. Thank you that the blood of Jesus is stronger than any spiritual force in the world. So I thank you, Lord, our homes are covered. Our homes are healed. Our homes are strong in the foundation of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. God bless you. We so appreciate Brooklyn Tabernacle. When you start gathering together, I'm going to try to get my family together and come down and visit you. But thank you for your time. Now let's go seek God together.
So now we have heard the word of God, and now what we want to do as the music is going to be playing is spend time in the presence of the Lord. Spend time in the presence of the Lord. You can do that right where you are. You don't have to go to church. Christian religion has nothing to do with buildings, cathedrals, churches, altars, pulpits, nothing. It has to do with an open heart, trusting and having communion with God through our Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. So whatever you're facing, whatever God has stirred up through the message we just heard, let's go to the throne of grace together and wait there. God bless you.